Ever thought that you were dumb because you failed basic algebra in high school? Well, fear not, because Baltimore parents sue the city after a student graduates high school not being able to read. Yeah, you heard that right. And there's more to this story than just that. What's trippin', guys? I'm Dripthulu, and this is taking NA education to a whole different fucking level. So to be specific, this article isn't only about that one case because there's so much more than just that, which I'll get to later in the video. And no, the parents are suing after hearing the reports, so they're basically doing on behalf of the people. It's not their child that can't read, but for now, let's start with the woman who graduated while being illiterate. Two parents in Baltimore, Maryland have filed a lawsuit against their city and its school district in response to shocking reports about the progressive city's abject failure to educate children. Earlier this year, local news outlet WBFF-TV highlighted the story of a woman who graduated from the Baltimore City public school system without being able to read. So the woman in question is named Deborah Pastelia, who is 41 years old and graduated back in 1999. 23 years later, she still can't read. So now, a lot of us might think that her parents are fucking assholes, the school board is a bunch of cocksuckers, and she herself could have tried to learn. Well, the story is a bit more than just that. To sum it all up, she has a learning disability and she's partially deaf, making it stupid hard for her to learn. Obviously, to help with this, she received help. Sort of. Not really. Quote, she says she was given an IEP, or an individualized education program, designed for students with learning disabilities. With an IEP, she should have been given extra help, tutoring, and specialized lessons. Instead, she says, she was given answers. What the teachers would do, instead of spending extra time with her to make sure she learns, they would just give her an answer sheet and let her write the answers down so that she didn't fail. And apparently she somehow passed fucking English in her senior year with a 68, despite not being able to read any of her assignments. So when she was younger, she was like most people, she had dreams. She dreamt of being married, becoming a vet, and having kids. And normally I'd probably make jokes here, but this is pretty fucked up. Like, she gave up on her dream of becoming a vet because she knew that she literally would not be able to make it. And on top of that, she refuses to have kids as well because she wouldn't be able to teach them or help them with their homework or anything like that, really. And she believes that they'd end up becoming just like her, which she doesn't want. So at the time of the article, she never became a vet, she never had children, and all of her dreams fucking destroyed. Fortunately, though, she does have an understanding husband that helps her with everything, but it doesn't change how shitty her situation is. Now, you may be wondering, what about the rest of the students that are in that schooling district? Because it's pretty damn clear that no one gives a fuck about them. Well, apparently at one of the high schools, 77% of the students read at an elementary level, which probably means nothing to you because what the hell does elementary level mean anyway? Elementary level is the lowest level of reading, where you're trying to figure out what the sentence is even saying in the first place. At this level, those kids are practically just looking at weird lines and squiggly shapes and trying to figure out what letters those are and what words those letters make. I just put a sentence on screen. Probably isn't that difficult to read, is it? Well, imagine taking said sentence and then giving it to your 3-year-old cousin who's just learning what words are. That's the equivalent that 77% of those students at that specific high school read. And by the way, most kids can competently read by the age of 6 to 7. Fuck me dead. And if you think that's the worst of it, it ain't. Because apparently, 41% of Baltimore City Public School high school students earn below a 1.0 GPA. To translate, a 4.0 is a 100, or an A. A 3.5 is around a 90, or a B+. 1.0 is like a 65 if the minimum to pass a test is 65 out of 100. 1.0 is the absolute bare minimum to pass something, which means that 41% of all high school students in the Baltimore City public school system are completely and utterly failing in all areas. Like, not just a class here or there, they are completely fucking not even passing a single class. What the fuck? How can anyone just look at this sort of shit, stick their thumb up their ass, and do nothing about it? This is the definition of ruining people's lives before said people have had the chance to even start it. What kind of complete dipshit loser do you have to be to allow this kind of stuff to go on? So, as I've said before, the parents are suing the hell out of the city. Their case is that the city officials and the BCPS have failed to educate the area's children and are wasting taxpayer money. They hope that this lawsuit sends a message to all those dollar sign worshipping dick lickers that this sort of bullshit won't be tolerated any longer. And to that I say, kudos to them. Good fucking on them for taking matters into their own hands and giving a good smack down to a bunch of corrupt assholes who are probably all dipping their hands in the money pile and shoving as much of it as possible in their pockets. Honestly, I hope that all those stupid, selfish cockwaffles get their lives torn to absolute shreds. The fact that they're willing to profit over destroying the lives of children is atrocious, and anyone there that's proven guilty for embezzlement or fraud or any of those financial crimes related to the failure to improve the school should be fucking tossed in the big cage. Man, I wish all those that are guilty of this could just suddenly forget how to read and write. Let those filthy wastes of life get a taste of their own medicine. I'll be fucking laughing when they look like dumbasses trying to buy milk from the store but they can't read any of the labels. Anyway, that's my piece. I have a question for you guys. Do you prefer shorter videos like this, or do you prefer 7 or 8+ minute videos? Leave it in the comments because, well, I want to know what you're thinking. Also, if you guys have any topics you want me to talk about, or you see something spicy online and you want me to make a video on it, go ahead and leave in the comments as well, as well. I need more material. See you all later. Have a decent day. Ja.